Hello and welcome to the build along video for this tracker knife. The process starts with a brand new purpose made piece of N690 stainless steel. The steel is marked out with blue layout die so that I can then scratch the template of the knife onto the piece of steel so it's there for future grinding. I use a scribe that I made from a broken piece of carbide end mill, which I've then sharpened to a taper in order to scratch permanently into the steel. I can also then use the same piece of carbide as a center punch, which is great for lining out where the holes need to be. The part is then loaded into the milling machine where I go around and drill all the appropriate holes. I then mark out and drill all the bottoms of the holes that are going to be used for the saw on the back of the blade. And last but not least, I drill a couple of 3mm holes for fitting the bolster and a couple of 6mm holes for the stainless steel handle pins. I then head to my trusty 4-inch angle grinder with thin cut-off discs in order to cut out the profile of the knife. I then cunningly fitted one of these thin cut-off discs onto a mandrel, fitted it into my milling machine, put a big vise on the milling machine that I could hold the blade in, and then used that to cut down to the edges of the holes that I had drilled previously in order to create the cutouts for the saw. Using this method ensures that I'm going to get the rake on each tooth to be exactly the same angle. I had left some excess material around the blade in order to make sure it remained nice and stiff for cutting out those teeth. I then went around with the angle grinder again and just removed a few last bits before we took it to the profiling on the bench grinder. I then scribe a center line as to where the actual blade edge is going to be, fit it into my flat grinding jig, and go and put on the primary bevel. Then, using a carbide tool and a Dremel, I start to make the filework impressions in the back of the blade. Unfortunately, a lot of this detail can't be done with a Dremel, so the majority is then done with diamond files. The whole knife is then carefully wrapped with all the edges folded and hammered tight in order to keep the blade away from oxygen whilst it's in the kiln. This helps to prevent things like decarburization, which is bits of the steel actually burning out of the steel and leaving pits in it when it gets above 1000 degrees C. The blade's then put in the kiln, and the kiln is ramped up through three different temperature cycles and allowed to rest at those cycles for a period of time in order to soak the temperature through the entire thickness of the 5.5mm thick steel. Once it's soaked at 1040 degrees C for over 20 minutes, it then comes out, it's clamped tightly between two thick aluminium plates, and then we blow compressed air at the blade and the plates in order to expedite the removal of the heat, which ends up hardening the blade. Then after two temper cycles of 2 hours a time, the blade is then looking like this. We then head over to the surface grinding attachment that I've whipped together in order to just clean up all that mill scale. I then grab out a new bar of 316 stainless steel and cut off two equal sized sections that I'm going to use to make the bolsters for the knife. It's imperative that these bolster sections are 1000% flat against the flat edges of the blade steel, so that when the material is removed you don't get any witness lines between the blade steel and the bolsters. As you can see, these two parts are so flat, they actually stick together with surface tension. I then hold the two pieces together with a couple of size for size drill bits, which holds them equally in the right place, whilst the profile is then ground away on the belt grinder. I then set my work rest to a 45 degree angle in order to shape the front edge of the bolsters. I then flip them around and do the inside dovetail at the same 45 degrees. I'll then use the same angle again in order to taper the handle material so that we end up with a perfect fitment for a handle into the dovetail on the back of the bolster. I ensure that all the final sanding of the blade is done before we then attach the bolster, as it's very pretty much difficult slash impossible to do once the bolsters are attached. I then cut off a couple of pins from some stock doweling material that I'm going to use to attach the bolster. It's important to note that this material is also 316 stainless steel, which is exactly the same material as the bolsters, so that when the two are pressed together, both materials will look identical and you won't get any shadow witness lines where it transitions from one type of steel to another. And you'll leave it with a nice, seamless appearance. So here's the knife put together with the pins and the bolsters. I just need to now go and do a little bit of final finishing on the front edge of those bolsters so that when they're fitted to the knife, no further finishing needs to be done. We then take that same knife assembly over to the hydraulic press, where those pins are smashed under about 12 tons of pressure into that bolster and the knife, which makes for a permanent seal so that thing is never coming off unless you drill it off or grind it off. As you'll see now, we'll take those pins and the bolster over to the grinder. A little bit of linishing later, and you'll see that those pins have completely disappeared. So now we make a start with the handle. What we have here is a nice quality piece of dyed and then resin infused and stabilised maple, which is burl maple. So it's got a really beautiful figure to it, which you'll see when the knife is done. I then cut two pieces of 1mm thick G10 out on the bandsaw, rough up both sides of it with sandpaper in order to key it in to give the glue something to stick to, and then these are glued up with epoxy after being cleaned with acetone and left to cure overnight. As a little tip here for other knife makers, if you put a couple of layers of masking tape onto your clamping surface beforehand, then any glue that squidges out means you can still A, pull your scales off the table when they're done, and B, saves you a lot of hassle trying to chip that glue back off your table. I then glue up one half of the handle only. I ensure that the new liner is put into the dovetail and then everything is double, triple, quadruple checked before it's clamped down, and then after it's clamped down, and then pretty much every 10 minutes until the glue has gone off, in order to make sure that everything has stayed exactly where we wanted it, then that's left overnight to harden. Once it's hard, then we go back and use the holes in the tang of the knife in order to drill through that first piece so that we know those holes are going to line up perfectly. We then glue on the other side of the knife scale. Again, clamp everything up, make sure nothing moves. And then once that's set overnight, then you can go back and use the holes you just drilled to go through to drill the other side. And that way you're guaranteeing that everything is going to line up perfectly, where you then put your knife pins through and cinch everything together. Okay, so now everything's glued up. We then go to start doing some final shaping. You start with the profile and then go on from there. Whilst doing all the handle shaping, I take particular care to make sure that the blade is completely masked up so that there's no chance of putting a little scratch accidentally onto that nice finished surface. Once all the roughing out has been done on the belt grinder, I then go to hand sanding and shaping for all the finishing touches. All of the edges are then trimmed up to make sure they're a perfect 90 degree angle to the rest of the blade using a horizontal sanding attachment, and then on to finish the bolster cutouts with the Dremel. Once that's done, everything is then hand sanded, every grit size up to 1200 grit before I then take it to the buffing wheel. And again, because this is resin infused, stabilised wood, there's no wood finishes as such in the traditional sense, other than just basically polishing that on the wheel. Here we have the finished knife. Again, after this, I put on a 30 degree main bevel on the curved edge and left the small cutout on the underside pretty much as a zero bevel Scandi grind. If you would like me to build a knife for you or for someone special in your life, please get in touch.